YouTubers. This is Average Joe Video back again. We have Winter Storm Scott that's pounding the region. Not really as much snow as I thought, but it is supposed to be a longer duration. So one of the things I'm doing this time is I'm actually going to go ahead and I'm going to plow here in the middle of the storm. I don't typically do that, but it is Sunday evening. I want to try to plow before it gets completely dark out here. I do want to mention to you, and this is an update since the last time. First of all, I appreciate everybody's feedback. I'm learning as I go here, so what we're going to do today is I'm going to follow the technique of angling my blade when I get to those points. We still have to help out the neighbor today, but one thing you are going to notice that's totally different is I have a Kubota accessory now on my snowplow, and that is a Kubota factory rubber cutting edge. So if you are wondering, there is a rubber cutting edge available for the 60-inch utility blade. It took me some digging to find that, and once I was able to see a forum online that mentioned the accessory number, it was very simple for me to acquire that. I actually went through Messix. Many of you are already familiar with Messix Kubota channel. You see Neil on there all the time. The gentleman I dealt with there was fairly new to the sales department. Excellent service. I actually called on a Saturday, and I had the Kubota accessory at my house delivered on Wednesday afternoon. So you can't ask for much better service than that. So I'm going to show you the rubber cutting edge in action. If you have questions about that, make sure you comment below. I know there's not really any videos out there with a Kubota BX factory blade with the rubber cutting edge. I think it's truthfully because a lot of people aren't even aware that it's an option. One of the reasons why I went with that rubber cutting edge is because I have such an uneven driveway that when I use the steel cutting edge, I'm forced to set the blade up. In other words, lower my skid shoes to keep from hitting that steel cutting edge on the lip of the concrete. And that's why a lot of people have been saying, you know, you're not scraping it down the whole way. But let me tell you, this blade is completely different. And you're going to see that too when I show video of the back dragging. So let's go ahead and get started.